Good morning, everyone, and welcome to the special board meeting for public hearing this Tuesday, June 8, 2021. I'd like to call the meeting to order, and may we have a motion for adoption of the agenda? It's been properly moved and seconded. All right, it has been properly moved and seconded, discussion.
Madam Chair, you know, we're in somewhat of uncharted territory with the citywide elections. Saying that right now we have two representatives in District 4 and then District 2. And so I would like to request that any votes that we have be filed.
Yes.
I think that was it.
Okay.
So, but if we're not, if we're not scheduled for a vote today, then there's nothing in the book.
All right, thank you for your comments, Mr. Hyatt. Superintendent Simon? Well, I was just going to point out that this district has not received a formal document associated with the statements that we were heard of at this point. So we don't have any formal reason for that. All right, thank you for your comment. All right, Ms. McGraw, you're right in here. All right, thank you. Talking with our school board attorney for the board members, I think we are in agreement, Mr. Hyatt, that we do need to move forward until we get any further information. Nothing has been clear except for what we've been seeing in the days so far, on TV20, Channel 4, but we do not have anything in writing from anyone. So at that point, what further discussion? Ms. Thurston?
I would like to talk to you about comments from the district.
All right, thank you. Any further discussion? Mr. Hyatt? All right, thank you so much. If you turn your light off, all in favor? All right, opposed? The adoption of the agenda, and also, we did not, let me go back. We did not have, after Mr. Hyatt's comment and the superintendent's comment, I think I should have called at that point, Ms. Attorney Heitzelitz. Was I supposed to call for the vote for that, or died because of a sentence? Okay, all right. All right, thank you. Then I stand okay to move forward. At this point, I'd like to call on Attorney, if she would come forward.
Thank you, Madam Chair. Members of the board, Dr. Simon, we are here for a public hearing that was scheduled for 11 o'clock this morning for the proposed new and amended job description for administrative professional medical and education support. Attorney, can I
see if it's the mic is on? It sounds like it doesn't.
It does.
Okay.
Do you want me to better now?
Yes, ma'am, I do.
Okay. Do you want me to repeat?
Yes, would you mind?
Right. We are here for a public hearing that was scheduled for 11 o'clock a.m. for proposed new and amended job description for administrative, professional, technical, and education support professionals. There have been a few changes since our first reading. There were four specifically that have been outlined. They've been given to members of the board. They've been put on the website as well. And at this point, I would open the floor to public comments, specifically on this agenda item.
Okay. I'd like to say, if I can make a comment at this point, Attorney, to our citizens who are here and our citizens who may be calling in or watching from home, we are going to maintain what we are here for today on the discussion job descriptions and anything that would pertain to that. But any other comments, and this will be the same for 6 o'clock this afternoon, I'll ask that you save all of those comments for citizen input at our meeting that's coming up next week. So, attorney.
Yes, attorney. I would ask that you open the floor to the public comment on this. I'm not sure.
All right, if we should have any citizens that would like to have comment according to what's here on the agenda, please speak now. I have one citizen, Ms. And I hope I'm pronouncing your name correctly, DeBosio. Did I say that pretty good? Basso, thank you. I'm so sorry for that incorrection. Next week, according to your topic here, we would be able to accept that on at our regular business meeting. But this meeting pertains basically to our descriptions of jobs. Would you mind going to the mic, and then I will inform you at that point where we are and what we need to be able to do. And give your name, please.
Sure. My name is Dee Basso, B-A-S-S-O, and I am here because I have a textbook from third grade social studies that has some inaccuracies in it. Okay, it's a concern of mine. And because of what is going on with recovering new teachers and whatnot, I want to make sure that these teachers are properly educated to know that there's errors in textbooks. And I have concerns as to how they wouldn't know that there's a distinct error and why they would teach something that is inaccurate.
Yes, ma'am. I do, now that you have explained it clearly, we will certainly accept your input on next week at our business meeting on the 15th.
Okay, now I ask why you would not want to hear that now when it does.
The reason that we cannot hear it now is because we are mainly talking about the positions that are listed here for consideration, but with anything about something different from that, you know, if you want to tell me about the position or have a comment about that, you're welcome to do that within your 3 minutes. But as far as curriculum or anything that pertains to the classes that students will be involved in, no, ma'am, next week would be appropriate at that time.
Okay, and the reason that I thought it was appropriate is because...
Yes, ma'am, I understand that.
I make sure that our teachers that are going to be teaching the correct curriculum.
Yes, I completely understand. But if you would save those comments for next week, I would certainly appreciate it. Thank you. I see no other comments. Ms. Ward, does it pertain to job description? Because that's all that we want to do today.
I'm Carmen Ward. I'm the president of the ACEA, and so I represent the bargaining unit of employees. I did want to say that in the superintendent's vision, I quoted that she said ESSER funds address many of our goals. And in those job descriptions, how ESSER funds are going to be used for these reoccurring positions is confusing to me. And also, again, I do want to say that the union does need to have a seat at the table in not frittering away the multi-millions of dollars coming our way, but making sure they're used to support learning and support the classrooms and support our bus drivers and support everyone in this public school system that has a role. So I just wanted to put that out there once again, that we are ready to be invited to discuss how ESSER funds are going to be spent. And I have just a question about the emergency manager position, because during the times that we're not in emergency, it seems like that is a lot of dedication of resource for emergency situations in the school system. I just have a little question about that. And also, the wherever SBAC used to be, we try to put ACPS, I'm thinking, and I noticed that on Chief of Police as well, that it's Chief of Police of SBAC instead of ACPS. So I was just, those were the things I wanted to add today about this. So, that's all. Thanks.
Thank you, Ms. Moore. Any other citizens? Any callers? Okay. Superintendent Armand? I do want to make a modification, and this board reminded me of that. We received some feedback in emails from citizens, and one point was presented that I believe you all were copied on in the email my response, but I will address it. The concern was actually the chief of police position, that the terminology of police presents an image that we are perhaps, you know, having more influence of some form of law enforcement, and I think that is actually not the intent. The intent is really to focus on safety and security. And so I would like to withdraw that job description, because the only association in the job description was the title change. And so it would actually just go back to what it currently is, which is the Chief of Safety and School Security. Okay, so it really is just in the job.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you. Yes, you have the job. Thank you.
They just told me that I can come in and speak out of that side.
Well, I'm not sure what the topic is about.
It's about job description, about the organizational procedure, with that you're changing the organization. The only thing I want to say is that...
Before you start, please give us your name.
Simon Graham.
Thank you, Mr. Graham.
The only thing I want to talk about is how the construction department is set up now, and the organizational portion of it, making sure that there's someone who's leading the construction and facilities department that really understands the need for selections and setting up things right for actually the African community, African American community here. That's the only thing that I look at is what is changing or what is happening in that particular department, and that's all.
Okay, thank you so much. The other citizen, do you have a comment? Okay. Seeing none. We are now at number two. Number two would be the proposed changes since the first reading that was held on May 18, 2021.
Yes, ma'am.
And those are the four that were provided, both to the board and to the public. So I would ask that you open the floor to public comment on the changes.
Thank you, attorney. We have that the floor is now open for any comments, citizens, as well for proposed
As far as the public hearing goes, we would just ask to recess the public hearing until 6 p.m., this piece of it, so that we can get the opportunity for additional citizen input.
All right. Before we move to that portion, I would like to let everyone to understand that this is basically a recess until 6 p.m., where we will reconvene in this room to continue the discussion. But I see that we have board discussion at this point. So, Dr. Simon and then Ms. Thurston and others. Thank you, Attorney.
I think because of the recess component, I wanted to kind of add information and I'll bring it at 6 o'clock as well. To respond to Ms. Ford's statement about the emergency management coordinator position, oddly enough, I just yesterday was asked to join the EOC to talk about how we are going to be managing all hurricanes. Our facilities are a part of this as far as shelter, so there is a need for that type of coordination. On top of it, COVID has complicated how we actually shelter during our hurricanes and all of that, so it's a bit more, and the additional component is because the COVID task force is going to be absorbed in, this would be a person who would take on those additional roles. Oddly enough, I will have to say that in this situation, we have emergencies that happen throughout the year. It's not kind of a one-and-done type of thing, and especially our hurricane seasons last quite some time. So I think this position is important. On top of it, the EOC had mentioned that a good county for us to collaborate with is Orange County. Seems to have a very successful coordinator in their emergency management office that they thought we should talk to. And the feedback that I received is that the county was very pleased that we had an individual dedicated to this position. Thank you, Dr. Simon. Ms. Hyatt?
Thank you, Madam Chair. I had an outdoor workshop Wednesday. The next day I went and see Dr. Simon, who had a was nice enough to send me out and then out of his office, and I really appreciate it at the time. And one of the questions I have, and it is something that maybe we could address a little bit this evening, or even with Mr. Wellow or Dr. Simon. I was on with the HR. I was thinking about, I thought it was very clear, the superintendent said, that many of these jobs are two-year positions, and the reason for that is that that's how long we have the money, and that in 2 years, we'll be in position to reconsider and see what needs to stay and what we can afford to have to pay. In other words, it's a two-year position. So I just wanted perhaps a little more clarity as to is this going to be clear in the job description that there are 2 year positions, and are we planning for 2 years down the road where we might have to lose some employees? I understand the whole idea of grant money, having been around the university long enough, where there are positions that are specifically grant funded. But the question is, are we going to have people in there that will need to find another position, or not renew them because of the funding? So, I think that would be an answer tonight would be great for me, and I'll feed it right now. If you'd like to talk to it right now, that's fine.
But I don't get the position.
I just have to deal just mentioned that we always, it's something that Dr. Paulson talks about quite a lot, is that we, always have some attrition. So that would be something also to consider. But thank you very much, Madam Chair.
Would you like to wait until this evening, or do you want to address them? have to hear it in both places, and then he and our audience seems to join in at certain times. So we have spoken with Mr. Hyatt, and Mr. Roller and I have spoken quite a bit as well as we've had discussions with HR. This is not, I mean, soft money has been in existence for quite a considerable amount of time, and so having positions that are funded through soft money is not new. I think what we have done is we have looked at positions that we will need in order to do these efforts, and over time, things are going to change. We do know that we will have retirements in the future, as well as other individuals who choose to leave the district for other reasons beyond retirement. We are looking at these situations, as well as when I presented that this is it's a two-year focus to make sure that we have the right hands associated with the work that needs to be done in order to make sure that this $90 million is watched in a responsible way. I can tell you now that, I mean, with my background in finance and with Alex Rella serving as our CFO, I feel very confident that we are making these decisions and we're being very responsible with how we're handling the money, as well as being thoughtful with how we communicate what's going on with individuals who apply for these positions.
Thank you.
I do want to just throw something out there as well, because this was mentioned in citizen input, and I believe Ms. Certain also brought it up. It's not in these job descriptions, but I do want to kind of present it to the board that we will be slowly modifying some of our job descriptions, like the vocational tech position, to align with current standards, and one of which I'm chagrined to even admit that I was using the term guidance counselor when school counselor is something like that. Was a guidance counselor way back when, and I realized it's a hard habit to break. So we will also be moving toward redoing those job descriptions as well to align with some of your concerns.
Situation that's come to light, and the email that you've all received, you've been copied on from citizens, kind of bring up a few things that are really concerning. Today's meeting, I thought what came up really today from the meeting today was unnecessary, because in this meeting, at the end of special meeting, there was no voting to take place in this meeting. So I think, in the past, we've all, despite our differences, on the board, we've all tried to be collegial, but it seems that something has really gone off the rails here of lately, and people are attacking a fellow board member, and even one of our own seem to be taking a jab at her when we don't have all the facts on that. There's a small vocal group making unsubstantiated accusations without having all the facts. This is not about where our colleague is. It's about overturning the election. This is from the Trump playbook, straight out of the Trump playbook. Their candidate didn't win, and now they're trying to unseat Mr. Block, who was elected countywide by the citizens, the majority of the citizens of Alachua County. Those citizens voted for change, and I understand now that there's a small local group of people who are trying to overturn the vote of the people. And as I said, we tried to be collegial in the past, despite our different philosophies and ideas of how we're supposed to move forward. But to me, that path is going to be And I feel really just some kind of way about how our colleague was here just a few minutes ago, when we have nothing official from the governor's office, from the Secretary of State. We don't even have anything from our local supervisor election. Not just having seen anything like that, so it's very disturbing. I was further disturbed because I received an email, which all of us did, from a citizen. But another citizen then gave to me Mr. Hyman's response to her from his board email account. And that's okay, he's free to respond however he wants. But what is really concerning is that it seems that one of our own is joining forces with those who are trying to destroy public education. He was delighted or encouraged that she sent this email to the Education Commissioner, to Senator Keith Perry, to Chuck Quinlan. And it just seems that, you know, you're undermining one of our own without having all the facts, without seeing anything in writing that's official that states that she does not live in the district. So it's to me, as I said, I don't think this is about the number of lawmakers. This is about a group of people in this county who this loan, because they didn't win seats in the 2020 election, and now they want to overturn the election and win the people. It's not about where Ms. McGraw is. Really what it's about is what the failure of past boards did and what past district staff did do with those boards. Let's place it there if you want to start pointing fingers. But I think it's unfair to start out this meeting and to say she shouldn't vote when we don't have anything official to be trying to do it. That's not our place to remove her and to tell her that she cannot function. She was duly elected countywide, sworn in, and she took her oath of office. And we should stand on that and support that until we get something otherwise. So I guess the question is to ask, is Mr. Hyatt aligning himself with the men, Alachua, Ward, Scott, Perry, Clinton, Tim Martin, who are trying to actively destroy public education? You know, I mean, it was really just moving to me that when the citizens met with me yesterday and gave me a copy of this email from Mr. Hyatt that says, thanks for your email. See?
I'm not trying to trick you off in any manner, but I see another light that's on, and I know that there is going to want to be an address of what you have stated. I want to allow that, but then once that statement has been made, I'm going to close this meeting, and I'd like for us to note to the Sun through Mrs. Peck that we may have a special meeting for all of us. And going along with many of the things you said, but inasmuch this is a public meeting, I'm going to stop you right there, let him have his say, and then we will continue deliberating, but we will notice it, and we will go from there.
Thank you, Madam Chair.
Thank you.
Madam Chair, if I may, since I have this act. Let me first of all say, for no certain, I have to accuse anyone else of being out of Alachua with her and Facebook presence over the last several years is a little rich. But I will say that this is a very simple question. And if you notice, we're dealing with obfuscation rather than the only question at hand. The only question at hand is, are state laws being violated? It's not, and for me to be, lined up with all the other, right-wing folks that you named, it is a little bit silly and actually just not looking at what the question is. My question, and I do want to say this about supervisor margins.
we're not going to hear from them. Because just like the school board, they have no investigative power. They have none. School board has none. And also to make a correction, I did not say that Ms. McGraw should not vote. I said the board should not vote. The board should not be making major decisions when we have a situation that has divided this district. Now, for me to be attacked when I'm talking specifically about I think state statute's pretty clear. And you're looking at an attorney, and I do not know what the correct remedy is. The remedy, there are three ways that it can be determined. One, Ms. McGraw could step down, which is not. She made that very clear. And I'm not asking it. But that would solve the problem. The other would be if the governor brought some money. If the governor could be a lawsuit. But, when I write an email, it is public record. So I don't have any problem. If we're going to play that little game, then I can certainly pull out a bunch of screenshots that have been sent to me over the last few years, over the last couple of years. So I'm just I'm very disappointed that instead of, this was not caused by me. This was not caused by anyone else other than the parties involved. So, I'm not sure exactly how you expect this to be resolved when you're calling an agency that has no investigative power to do it. So, I'll let that go for now. And if we want to, have a public meeting and do this, if we're just going to ignore massive numbers of citizens, and if you think that the state law applies just to one party or the other party, that's not true. We all swore to uphold the laws, the Constitution, the laws of the United States, the state of Florida. That's what we all did. So, thank you, Madam Chair.
Thank you, Mr. Hyatt. Thank you, Ms. Certain. And let me say this before I move to Dr. Simon and Mrs. McGraw. And Ms. Certain, please consider. You can. Okay. With all of what's been going on in our community most recently, I'm somewhat distraught and disappointed. And some of the things that you stated, Mr. Hyatt, are true. And many of the things that Mrs. Sutton has stated is true. But as far as holding up the vote, whether you say it, Mrs. McGraw or the board, as chairman, I'm not in agreement with that. We have too many priorities, responsibilities, challenges facing this board. And until we get to the end of whatever this discussion is leading us to, we are going to vote. Dr. Paulson is absent today, but we will take our votes. There was no vote scheduled for today, but come Tuesday, when there will be our business to contend with for this district, we will be voting. And I'm hoping that all five of us will be here to vote. And I hope that after our statements today, nothing else will be stated about anyone. I don't like it. Some things needed to be stated and gotten off of our chest. Both of you have that opportunity. But it's done. I'm going to Dr. Simon, and then I'm going to Mrs. McGrath.
Thank you, Chairman Hammond. So in light of this discussion and in light of the information that was shared last week through the petition, the district has been doing internal discovery as far as what we have in our documents, as far as any sort of board minutes, recordings, and all of that. One of the things, and this is just some information for the public, so generally what happens is after a census, which is every 10 years, the government entities look at the populations and determine if they need to examine their precincts and how we do redistricting of voting groups. And so that goes into a resolution. And so then the school district, the school board, would vote on a resolution that approves the districting for voting for the board members. The last recorded redistricting resolution was done August 21st, 2001. We have been talking to attorneys who were present during 2011, which would have been the last census, which I will note, we have a census that just occurred. So in this process of all of this, that we have realized that we will be looking into doing a 2021 district decision. But what ends up being extra complicated about this situation is that the resolution from 2001 was the last recorded vote that is required in statute, that does have to go to the clerk of courts, it does have to go to the Department of State. We know that that's the last one we have. We've done our internal workings to find out if there was anything. Like I said, when we talked to our attorneys, it turns out that in 2011, that's the other thing about this, is that you can only do this in odd years. So in 2011, there was a discussion with the supervisor of elections. We have this by the district attorney at that time, as well as the board attorney at that time. And it turns out that there was a delay of getting the information from the supervisor of elections to look at the population numbers. And so the window, it is essentially what happened is it became 2012, the window closed. The window would have opened again in 2013, but it appears as though there was not a decision to do the redistricting. So the last time this resolution occurred was in 2001. The additional complication is, in 2001, we had 53 precincts, not 71. And so this election that has occurred has been on 71. On top of this complication, we do have a series of maps, and we're still in this area where we're trying to figure out this process. So when we do the 2021, we'll understand how all decisions were made. But the map seems to have changed. And so right now we are in discussions with the FAGS department, or FAGS organization. We know that they're right now reaching out to the governor because there are components that are complicating this situation a bit more. So I would say at this point we really don't know what the whole scope of the situation is to have any form of an assessment, at least on our end. Thank you.
I do appreciate that complicated explanation. I'm sure that that will come up again in the future with the person responsible for all of the investigations. But I do stand as chairperson of this board to say that until something comes to us in writing, we will not hold up the business at hand. But we will go forward with our June 15th board meeting, which there is a lot of business on the agenda. And we will not stop with our voting process because of anything that has not been cleared as of yet.
Did you understand that, Superintendent Simon?
Yes, ma'am. Mrs. McWell.
Thank you, Madam Chair. So to correct that, the vote, the school board, I'm about to go, the school board in the odd year has to look at the districts and make sure they are covered by how they're required to be covered. So this time, I cannot say much more by being the person, but that is where we are in a complex situation. Because of what was not, we're talking about following the law. We did not follow the law. We required to redraw the district after the school district is set. And so here we are in the odd year 2021, and everything is going to be said. The district is where we are. I do have responses from former staff attorney, up in the board attorney, regarding this matter. But thank you again, Madam Chair, and I will continue to serve all of the children here in Alachua County. I thank more than something. For sharing that this is at their office, and we met them back in August, and now for 2 months, 9 months, and this is about change. And so I just completely got feed on you and all the people who support me, and I appreciate that, and I continue to ask you to continue to pray that we will be able to move forward and make sure all the children in the life of God. Another thing that is LeBron. One of the things when Superintendent Simon was talking about resolution, the part that I got, and I don't want to belabor the point, but the fact of the matter that you were saying what part the school district plays in this whole mapping of districts, that would mean if we have not, since 2001, is it? Since 2001, that means that Dr. Paulson, Mrs. Certain, myself, Mr. Hyatt, we are all in with a problem. We all may need to step down because if you have, the resolution hasn't changed any of those odd years, then we are all suspect as far as our district. I see Attorney Turner's head nodding with me, and that makes me a little nervous. Let Simon and then Attorney.
I think this is why it's complicated, and so this is why we're reaching out. We are still very much at the investigation period because we're trying to figure out what is going on. There are some people who are no longer with us who were part of these decision makers, and some that are, as well as we're looking through all of our documents. And we have documents that go back to the 1800s, so there's a level of trying to really understand the scale and scope of this dilemma that we're in. But I would say it's fair to say we're in a fairly large dilemma.
All right. So, Mr. Hyatt?
Well, thank you, Madam Chair. I don't want to address all of the parts of the budget. I want to look forward. And but I fewer maps in the county rather than more maps. I hope that for the future, have nothing to do with this, with where all of us are now. And for the future, I hope that we could have the same number districts as the county commission. It would be less confusing. And when that changes, it wouldn't affect anyone's term who's already on the board. But when we get to that, that might be something that we can all consider. Thank you, Madam Chair.
Thank you, Mr. Howard. There's a certain Ms. McGraw. We need to have that money. Because I think all of us might be in trouble.
The only thing to add on that is we should consider we'll need the census data, and my understanding is that would be somewhere around October. It's been helpful for us because now we're trying to prepare, like, what are the steps that we need to take in order to do this, but the census data is crucial, and Mr. Hyatt's point that was presented has been something that we've been discussing internally as well, because although they do have the five, they're not all aligned.
Okay. This has been a robust discussion, and as much that we have a meeting at 6, we'll be at recess until then. I thank the citizens for being here with us today. I thank you for those of you who are listening, wherever you may reside or work. And we will come back at 6 p.m. Meeting adjourned.
Good evening, everyone. We are very grateful to all of you that have helped us out today. And to the administration, from the
our community is what we've lost the trust of our community. That's the feeling. And I really would like for us to solve the problem with the attendance before we go on, before we make further thoughts. I'm making a motion that we tell our lawyers to investigate, get the order that they need to get, and we get this out of the way no matter how it turns out. So that's my amendment. And I think it would be wiser if we could have this thing out of the way. It's really we have lost the trust of much of the group. You know, how we walk. So, that's my amendment. And if I can get a second, I appreciate it.
Now, Mr. Chair, I don't think it's in a board workshop. We did not take votes. We adopted an agenda earlier. And the member was not made, and I think that is our order that's not passed board practice, and I think that it would be imprudent to proceed along that line.
No, I appreciate that. I just want to connect with someone and say thank you for doing the job. And I just want them. A long record, but I think that we are in trouble with our community. And I just want to say that the trouble of our community, I think that sooner or later, we need to get this resolved. If we get it resolved, it'll be for the benefit of the work. So I appreciate that. I think we're enough to get it out of time. But I want to be on record of that. So I think that's what we need. And we go on for that. Thank you.
Thank you so much. Thank you, Madam Chair. I don't think we've lost the... I'm not sure what the indicator is to say that we've lost the trust of our community. So I'd like to go on record as saying that I disagree with that. I will say there's a small, hopeful group of people who are speaking, and as an elected body, I don't think for us, individual members, we have the authority to dismiss or to sanction one of our phone members who was elected, who, as all of us, qualified in good faith through the Supervisor Elections Office, who were each elected countywide by all of the citizens of Alachua County, and we do not, each of us, have the authority to suspend someone's vote or suspend the business of the district because there is this rumblement within our community. So I like to go on record and say I disagree with that, and I do thank you for not entertaining a vote during this meeting, as I said, because I don't think that's been our past practice to do that.
I just want to be clear. I am not asking us to make it final. I don't want us to be making the decision. I just want us to get involved and find out who will make the decision and get this behind it. Whether it's the governor or what. This is not something that we do not judge our federal board. If I gave that impression, that's completely wrong. All I'm saying is it's a distraction. That's a distraction, a big distraction. One I've never seen before in this country. So, again, I don't judge my fellow board member. I don't even pretend to judge. Well, that's not what I'm talking. I appreciate you giving me all the time from that. I just wanted to be clear. We're out of that. I disagree with you on the view. That's all I mean. Now, my fellow mayor, I'm allowed to agree with you. I think that you have the power to make a decision for the member. But only you at the end of the committee. I turned down, I'll live with it. You know how I feel. I hope we get through this for the sake of argument.
We will definitely.
still going to happen this morning, but I will.
Well,
so I guess.
Take a look at it.
My God, I'm trying.
My understanding is we have a call.
Thank you for being back.
Well, you are live with the board, and you have 3 minutes.
I also want to rise in support of the superintendent's positions for the plan last week, especially the job description. In order to move forward, we're going to need to have positions filled, and I support Dr. Simon's direction in this. And we need to be unified as a district, and I think this sets us on that she needs to have positions. She needs to be there, because it's imperative and critical that we do that at this time, in this junction, in this place.
Thank you for that. And do we have any further calls? Thank you.
Can you hear me? Hello? Hello?
Yeah.
Yeah, you can hear me?
Yes, yeah,
I can. Okay, so I just want to support Dr. Simon's superintendent vision. I'm very excited for this upcoming school year. I know that we're going to do great things as a school board. I'm hoping that we're going to do great things. I did listen on the previous school board meeting, and I'm very discouraged because some things that I thought that were said was not appropriate at all. And I'm standing in support of school board.
Anyone else here at the center that wants to talk about it? Seeing none, I think it's time.
The center believes that that would include the citizen in proportion of the public good.
Any formal rules and questions wanted to be